Okay, so we're here with Sujal Patel, who is the CEO, and you are you a founder of Isilon?
Yes.
Is that right? All right. So congratulations, first of all, on the acquisition.
Thank you very
tremendous
much.
Story. I mean, any storage companies left that are independent? I mean, I think they're all.
I don't think there are any.
Going, so, but I was just listening to your presentation to the analyst community. Thank you for that. I want to talk about big data. Can you talk about what big data means to customers and how things are changing?
So, when we look at the definition of big data, we've developed a working definition that is data sets or information that have scaled to the point where because of the amount of data or the need in terms of timeliness or because of the distribution of that data or how it's presented in separate silos, because of one of those reasons or many of those reasons, there's a need for a new storage architecture that can handle it. So this might be large stores of unstructured data or digital content or media or any sort of large data set that requires a new architecture.
Okay, so we need a new architecture because the existing architectures can't handle the volumes of data, is that right?
Well, it could be either volume or it could be performance, right? There's two major trends that are going on in the data center today. One is that the rate of data growth is far outpacing areal density increases in disk drives, which means that we have a need for applications to spread out across a lot more hardware than before. That requires a new architecture. Second is that the performance of Intel servers is exceeding Moore's Law, and applications are leveraging that with technologies like virtualization and newer applications based on clustered computing. Well, if you've got a scale and a performance level that's beyond what you can do with the traditional architecture, you've got to move to what we call these scale-out architectures today.
Now, when you started Isilon, you had said 10% of the data that was out there was unstructured, 90% structured, and now it's almost completely flipped. I think it's 75% is what you said.
Yeah.
So what led you to that conclusion? How did you see that? You know, what was your telescope saying?
It's interesting. So your numbers are absolutely right. So when we started Isilon, 10% of data was file, 90% was block. That was 2001. But 5 years prior to Isilon, I spent time at a company called Real Networks. They were the pioneer of streaming media on the internet.
Right.
And what we saw with the growth of media on the internet was the very beginning of what we knew was going to be a giant problem for all enterprises. And that problem played out a little bit faster, a little bit slower, but it played out just about like we thought it would. In 2008, data split just about 50-50, file and block. By 2012, it's going to be 80-20, file majority, block minority. And some point near the end of this decade, it's probable that even the storage dollars in terms of revenue will shift predominantly towards file as opposed to block.
So what do you think that means in terms of sort of the next wave? Is it now about getting value out of all that data? Is that what big part of what the big data is about? Or is there another sort of disruptive force that you're seeing?
Well, you're absolutely right. It is about getting value, right? Why have data if you can't analyze it for business value, if you can't distribute it, if it's media, if you can't distribute it and get entertainment value out of it? What good is it if it doesn't enable new innovations and new products to reach the marketplace? And that's really the goal, why customers have this big data.
Sujal Patel, you know, blockbuster acquisition in the storage business. You know, congratulations. Thanks for spending some time with SiliconANGLE and Wikibon community.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Yeah.
All right, so that was Sujal Patel from Isilon, and really appreciate you coming on. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
And just to sort of summarize what we heard in there, Isilon is the company that started out really trying to unify file systems, right? The NetApp sort of came on the scene and was big in terms of providing, you know, what I sometimes call chiclet filers, right? Little small filers. And of course, NetApp's, you know, begun to scale, but putting together, you know, little filers to big filers and trying to scale that up. Well, Isilon had a different vision. They said, what if we create a global namespace and a clustered file system and then allow the customer and the application to see a single global namespace, a single file system, if in fact that's what they want. Put a billion files in that single file system if they want, or maybe put, you know, 100 terabyte, you know, chunks of files in that. And that kind of flexibility is what made Isilon such a successful company. They did an IPO. And then with all the acquisition fever that went on, it's like an NFL on draft day. You know, somebody takes the first guard and then the second one goes and the next one goes. So Isilon was an asset that EMC saw as very scarce. There aren't a lot of companies that can create this type of global file system. And a lot of, aren't a lot of companies that are as successful, you know, in startup mode as Isilon. So EMC picked up that acquisition or that asset for about $2 billion, which a lot of people felt is very expensive. But if you look at some of the other acquisitions that have been going on, like 3PAR, we saw a big run up there. You saw the big run up on Data Domain a couple of years ago. Probably a very interesting part of EMC's growth strategy going forward. So Isilon, you know, still unclear how exactly they're going to organize that within EMC, but clearly we're talking about the big data trend, and there's some new assets inside of EMC that are supporting that trend. Isilon is one, Green Plum is another, and we're starting to see Atmos come back. We heard a little bit about the Hadoop movement today, and Hadoop and Atmos kind of fit together because that infrastructure is a distributed infrastructure. Hadoop is, remember, all about bringing the code to the data, which is distributed over the network, as opposed to trying to bring the data through a pipe into a data temple, into a big box, okay? So that's really where Atmos fits. So we're starting to see EMC put a few of the pieces of the puzzle together, and we're going to squint through that and look for more. This is Dave Vellante reporting from the Sheraton in Manhattan. Thanks for watching.